you have been evicted. Please leave the Big Brother house. Jermaine, you have been evicted. Please leave the Big Brother house.
His religion is so pure, and I am so proud to be a Muslim. I am so proud to have the opportunity to talk about how I feel and my experience. I am so proud to be a voice for some of the Muslims who are kind of in trouble. It makes me tear because I feel that you have to have it in your heart and you have to want to do good by others.
Jermaine, assalamu alaikum.
Alaikum salam.
Do you think Shilpa will be coming over to Bahrain and you maybe go to Mumbai and have some proper chicken curry?
Well, I would love to go to Mumbai. Michael's been, my other brother Jackie has been, but I have not been. But I love the Indian movies. I love the culture, the music. I'm very close to Adnan Sami, and I love the food. So yeah. I'm definitely going to go.
I hear Adnan Sami loves his food as well, so you got something in common. Yeah.
9:19 p.m. Shilpa is teaching Jermaine an Urdu phrase to say to his wife.
What is it that you wanted to know? I really missed you a lot, or I really love you a lot.
She already know that.
But you know, Urdu is a very romantic language.
I really miss you a lot.
Missed you a lot?
Yeah.
हमने आपको बहुत याद किया.
Oh no. No.
Why?
No, that didn't even start out right.
हम ने
ने
आपको
आपको
बहुत
बहुत
याद
याद
किया
किया
क्यों क्यों.
I won't be saying that.
You've been called the peacekeeper. You played the peacekeeper numerous times in that house. And on one final question, one final topic, we talk about making a change, and you made a change some years ago, a change in religion, a change in faith as a Muslim. How have you found being a Muslim? And how has it been in the Big Brother house being a Muslim?
Well, I'll tell you, if I did not have Allah in my prayer rug, I would not have survived. And the reason why is because it kept me focused, it kept me calmed, it kept me... It's the ultimate power and the ultimate calmness. Patronizing God and just knowing that He's the peacekeeper of all things, and that's what kept me calm.
There's a lot of speculation that you invited your brother Michael over to Bahrain recently, and that Michael may well be becoming a Muslim. Can you set the record straight for us on any of that?
Well, I'll tell you this. My pilgrimage to Mecca was in 889. Michael, I feel, needs to become a Muslim because I think it's a great protection for him from all the things that he's been attacked with, which are false. And I think there's a strength and there's a protection there.
Has he
with
shown
God.
Has he shown any interest in becoming a Muslim? Do you know? Has he mentioned it to you yet?
Well, I brought him a lot of books from my first trip, and he reads everything, and he reads a lot. And I think he's probably giving it a serious thought because he spent a lot of time in Bahrain. I was the reason why he had gone there, because I wanted him to get out of America and just go somewhere where it's peaceful and quiet, and people pray five times a day, which is beautiful. It's a beautiful thing.
Okay.
Beautiful.
Jermaine Jackson, thank you very much for spending time and speaking to us. Really, really am very grateful. And I think you've done a lot of people of all colours and creeds and faiths very proud being in that Big Brother house. Thanks very much, Jermaine Jackson.
Thank you very much.
Jermaine.
Haven't seen you for many years.
The house is wonderful. The people are very nice.
That's not my thing.
You're not mixed race, though. You are actually black, aren't you? Or is your mum white?
100% pure.
Both of you are both black. Now I've met Jermaine Jackson, I know I won't be struggling for someone to sing at my wedding.
I think Jermaine is just an amazing guy.
Oh, baby, give me one more chance. Won't you please let me back in your heart?
My brothers would be proud. They would be proud and laughing at the same time.
Hey.
And Jermaine's here, and we're delighted to meet you.
Thank you.
In our house, I think it's fair to say that we all hoped you would win, because we've been so completely mesmerised by your... Well, I mean, I don't know. Do you practice meditation or something?
No, it's just my prayers and just my fasting that keeps me calm and peaceful.
You were very zen, really, from start to finish. You never lost it. You never seemed thrown by anything. When things went wrong in the house, you were the one to calm things down a lot. I mean, the question that occurred to me was, watching you, what's this guy doing here? Why did you do it? Why did you come to on this extraordinary reality show?
Well, I'm recording with my brothers right now, and so we had a break, and so I said, well, why don't I try this? But 2 years prior to that, my father and I, we were in Berlin, and we visited the Big Brother house there, and so we took a walkthrough.
Got it.
And so my father asked me, could you do this? And I said, yes, this is a piece of cake. But I never thought that the opportunity would come 2 years later, and then there were some producers that came over and asked me, and I really wanted the challenge, and I felt that I've achieved what I wanted to achieve, which was last the duration of it, but I thought that I would have been booted out a long time ago.
Oh no, because you were such a calming influence all the time. But what you say, you fast and you pray. So what was going on with the meals then? You're a vegan, aren't you?
Yes.
So did you have your own special meals all the time?
I had plenty. I had all that I needed. Okay. I had my prayers, and I just had my peace within myself. My whole demeanor was to sort of keep my composure, and the prayer helped me so much. And the fasting, I fasted a lot inside the house, which was much harder for me because if I'm fasting at home, I can go and entertain myself by just looking at TV or something. But to sit there and not be able to leave those premises and then watch everybody eat, and I'm like, but doing my prayers, that kept me strong.
Your spirituality really did come across. And how long have you been converted to the Islamic faith?
Since 89, I did the pilgrimage to Mecca, and I'm complete. I'm whole now.
Which means what? How does that work?
There were so many questions that I had growing up as a Jehovah's Witness, and then a bit of Christianity, and I'm not against any religion, but I believe if one lives his life like God, then you are a Muslim, and if you live your life in God's will, so. I felt that once I converted, everything was full circle for me. And my purpose on earth is to try to be the best human being that I can be to others.
Well, it's interesting, isn't it? We've got this terrible conflict between East and West and Muslims and Christians. And what's the answer to us all trying to rub along together? Because we all have our own beliefs, and we must all be tolerant of each other. And basically the message is... love and peace, isn't it?
Yes. Well, I think my brother said it best with the song Man in the Mirror. And if you look at yourself first and make a change, then you can change for others, and you can change others. Mm. But you have to have that in your heart.
Now, at the start of the year, if you were asked to name one of the Jackson Five, Michael would have been the obvious choice. But 2007 has been the year for Michael's older brothers to return to the spotlight. Jermaine, of course, entered the Big Brother house, not realising that he was about to be at the eye of an international political storm. Whilst accusations of racism, bigotry and bullying swirled around him, Jermaine kept his cool and his dignity. He puts this down to his belief in Islam, and I caught up with him a few days ago to find out more.
A strong foundation creates secureness. Put it like this. We have to be bigger and stronger. We have to.
Well, Jermaine, I feel as if I've been virtually living with you for the last month, having watched you so much on Big Brother. What was your motivation for going in?
My motivation for going in was, well, first of all, I had visited the Big Brother set in Berlin, and I was with my dad and my nephew and my father kind of challenged me and asked me if I could do this, and I said, it's a piece of cake. And, and so I said, well, why don't I give it a try? And I thought I'd be kicked out in 7 to 10 days.
Were you hoping to be kicked out between 7 to 10 days?
Yes, but I was wrong.
How much did you use your Islamic faith when you were in there just to get by?
Every day, every moment, every second, just the prayers and just repeating Allah's name with my prayer beads every second, and just fasting and just keeping my composure and staying calm and staying peaceful.
Were you shocked in a way, though, that you had to use so much of your peacemaking powers within the house?
It kind of came naturally, because I saw disputes and things kind of brewing, and I was sort of like, would ease myself in there, just say, listen guys, it's calm down, it's going to be okay.
Jermaine says in some of the papers today that you are going to be interviewed by police because you allegedly said the words white trash. Now, I don't know what you have to say about that.
That was a statement that I had repeated that someone else said, and I was coming to Shilpa trying to explain to her to calm her down. But I have never looked at and never been raised to look at anybody as white trash.
How do you feel about the police interviewing so many of the girls in terms of racism?
I think it's getting out of hand, because these girls aren't racist, because let's think about it. If they were racist, would they have entered and slept in the same room with me and Shilpa? Would they have showered in the same room with me and Shilpa? That's true racism.
Let's talk about your conversion, because I'm sure many people in America and indeed within your family were surprised. How did that conversion to Islam occur?
Well, I took a journey to the Middle East in 89 with my sister Rebe, my oldest sister. It was during a time when my life was like, I was searching for completeness and sort of searching to be whole. And then we ended up going to Mecca, and I converted right then. So it was a calling that I felt that was in my heart and the right time to do it.
Your mom has a very strong faith in particular. Mm-hmm. She's a Jehovah's Witness.
Exactly.
Was she surprised? Was she very taken aback at the fact that you had converted relatively quickly by the sound of it?
She had heard about it before I got back, and she didn't treat me any different, but I'm pretty sure she noticed a change in me. But I found that converting to Islam and just becoming a Muslim during 9/11, when we were in New York doing Michael's 30th concert in New York, and the following morning, the next morning, the planes hit, and we were there. And during that time, a lot of Muslims around the world, young Muslims, kind of denied who they were and didn't want to say, well, I am who I am. And I found that very troubling.
But how do you view the fact that only this week, for example, we've had a number of arrests to do with alleged terrorism? So how do you deal with that?
It's extremist. It's not Islam. It's not representative of Islam. I think to take someone's life in your own hands is not Islam. And the fact that this religion is so pure, and I am so proud to be a Muslim. I am so proud to have the opportunity to talk about how I feel and my experience. I am so proud to be a voice for some of the Muslims who are kind of in trouble. It makes me tear, because I feel that you have to have it in your heart and you have to want to do good by others.
And I've read, whether it's true or not, I've read that you would like Michael, your brother, to convert to Islam. Is that true?
I think he should now. And the reason why is because there's so much being thrown at him. And
if I were to experience all the things that he experienced being a Muslim, I can deal with them because of my calmness.
Do you think he will convert?
I hope so.
How confident are you?
It's up to Allah, but I hope so.
Now, I hear lots of chat about the Jacksons reforming. Is it true?
Yes, well, my break from recording was the Big Brother house. So we were in the middle of coming up with some good music. So we're trying to get this album right because we have so many songs and so many different cultures and of music that we want to mix now. But we still got to keep it commercial, and of course.
Jermaine, thank you very much indeed, and I wish you every success in your various projects.
Thank you.
Very nice to meet you. Thank you for joining us in Heaven and Earth. Thank you.
Thank you. Yes, I am. Where is she?
I met her earlier on today. She's here.
Really? Well, I can't wait to see her.
And she can't wait to see you. I want to be a fly on the wall in the Jackson household tonight.